In this video, I'm going to be showing you how to install all new Revit 2026 on your computer. We're going to be discussing free and paid options. I'm going to be showing you the proper installation process, how to avoid a bug that I've noticed on the Autodesk website, and finally, I'm going to be showing you how to properly install the all-important Revit family libraries. Let's go. Now, quickly, before we jump into Revit, I would just like to ask you to check out my website, balkanarchitect.com. I'm going to link it up in the cards above and then also down in the description of this video. If you're serious about mastering Revit, that's definitely the best place to be. We are officially an Autodesk authorized training center, and we offer over 140 hours of content dedicated to all of the interesting and complex topics inside of Revit. Now, without any further ado, let's jump to the Autodesk website. And here we are on the Autodesk website. Now, as you can see, I'm logged in on my Autodesk account, and you need to be logged in. If you don't have an account, you can create one. Now, in terms of downloading Revit 2026 or any other version of Revit, please keep in mind that you do need to have an active license either to Revit or the AEC collection, which is what I have, that includes Revit. Also, there are free versions, so you have the free student license. This is only available if you're part of a high school or a university, and then you can use those credentials in order to get Revit. And also there's a 30-day free trial, so those are kind of the free options, and the rest of us, well, we need a paid license. Now, to access Revit 2026 or to download and install it, you need to go here to your account. You need to go to products and services, and here you need to search for Revit. So I'm just going to search for Revit, just like that. Here it pops up. Now here, I just wanted to show you this bug that I found out. Perhaps you may experience it as well, and I did find a solution, so I wanted to share that. So for example, here, when you go to Revit, you'll see that here it says Revit 2025, and it doesn't give us 2026, which is odd. If we go to view details, here it does show 2026. However, when we click on that, it seems to be a blank page. So now if I can go here through my menus and just gonna see what I have here and then go back to products and services, what I found is that now if I scroll down to Revit here, in this case it doesn't show, but I did this a moment ago on just another tab, and here it did bring up Revit 2026. So it's really odd, really weird. I don't know what's going on with the Autodesk website, but yeah, this is just what's going on right now. So I just wanted to let you know, just try going through these menus back and forth. And then when you go back to products and services, hopefully 2026 will pop up here. So anyways, we just need to go here to install. So just make sure that 2026 is selected. You have your operating system, the language, and you just click on install. And then you click on accept, and it's going to start the preparation for the install. Now it's going to download a file here, just like this. There we go. So I'm just going to click on that, and now we just need to allow it to make changes to our device. Next, you will have this window. So currently it's preparing the installation process. Now we're just going to follow the menu next. Here you need to specify the product location. I'm fine with this. So I'm just going to go to install, and now it's going to start the installation process. Now you can see here, as the installation is getting near the end, or in this case, I think it has been completed. Now we need to restart the computer. Now we can delay that. I'm not going to do that. I want to make sure that everything is installed properly. So I'm just going to restart the computer now. Now with the restart completed, we have the Revit 2026 icon here on desktop. And now let's start it for the first time. So I'm just going to double click here, and let's let it run. And here we go, it has been installed, so I'm just going to put it on full screen mode. And let's open up the architecture sample project just to see how that works, or what that looks like. And Yeah, it's opening it up. We can see it, it's in dark mode. I usually have Revit in light mode, but the rest of my system is in dark mode, so I'm guessing that's where it pulled that from. Let's open up the 3D view here. I'm really excited to test out to see if the accelerated graphics are going to be working now. Okay, so it looks like they are working in this production version of Revit, and yeah, it seems to be quicker. So yeah, this will be a complete separate video. It's just something that I've been interested in. If you've seen my full kind of breakdown of all of the new features, it wasn't working on the preview version I was using, so I'm excited to see that it's working properly right now. Also, another thing that I like to test as soon as I install Revit is to make sure that the family libraries have been installed. So if we just go here to the Insert tab and then go to Load Family, that's going to open up this menu. And here, as you can see, we don't really have any families loaded in. So let's do that now. So I'm just going to cancel out of here. For that, we need to go back to the Autodesk website, and then let's open up the Products and Services. And here we should be able to locate it now. So let's search for Revit. Hopefully it will work now. Okay, so now it's showing 2026. I don't know what's the deal with Autodesk with all of this, but yeah, it's a bug that seems to be going on. So anyways, here, when you go to the Revit page, you go to 2026, you need to go to Libraries, and then here you can see all of the content packs for Revit 2026. So what I'm going to search for is, let's see, something like, so I'm just looking for, let's go US English content for Revit 2026. So I'm just going to install that one. So I'm just going to hit download here. And there we go. So it's now in the process of downloading this content back. Now, once this has been downloaded, I can just open that up. You'll see that now it's extracting all of this content, and you need to install it now. So yeah, it's not as simple as just downloading files. It's going to go through an installation process to get all of these families. So you need to go here to install. And now we wait. And now, once this has been successfully installed, let's hit finish. And now I'm just going to restart Revit and see if the families are there. Okay, so let's open up a new project. I'm just going to use the metric template here. And then let's go to Insert, Load Family. And as you can see, now we do have proper libraries. If I go back, you can see, yeah, we even have the metric one. Yeah, perfect. So now I can just bring in any family that they like into Revit. So if you don't have the families or the libraries installed right away, this is how you get them into Revit. And that's going to conclude this video on how to download and install Revit 2026 and how to get all of the family libraries. I hope you have enjoyed this video. And if you would like to get access to all of my Revit project files, you can find that on my Patreon page, which I'm going to link up in the cards above and then also down in the description of this video.